Hello and welcome to Soccer Night. This week we've come to the recreation ground home of Ilminster Town.
We've got plenty to pack into tonight's show. All the latest from another dramatic week at Plymouth Argyle. A look ahead to the second round of the FA Cup and the latest from Yeovil Town with our special guest, Lloyd Owusu.
Yes, we'll be getting the inside track on life at Huish Park.
Well, Lloyd, welcome to Soccer Night. Top goal scorer at Yeovil this season, 8 goals. So how are you enjoying life in the West Country?
Enjoying myself a lot, Mark, thank you. Like you say, leading goal scorer, 8 goals at the moment. I'm really thoroughly enjoying it at the moment.
And a completely different life, I suspect, to what you had in London.
Definitely. London is the hustle and bustle, and I've come over here to Yeovil, Somerset, really slow. But like I said before, I'm really enjoying myself.
And what was it that tempted you to come to the West Country then?
It was really the manager, Russell Slade, really. He had a lot of faith in me after being out for a whole year. He had the belief in me to give me a contract, and I thank him a lot for what he's done for me this season.
Well, we'll talk more about Russell Slade, who's just signed a new contract himself, of course, later in the programme. Well, of course, despite Lloyd's efforts, Yeovil haven't managed back-to-back league wins since August. They suffered another setback at Millwall on Saturday. Here are the highlights from the new den.
Barry sends it short. Owusu. There's Barry again. They're queuing up in the middle. Still we can't clear. Oh, that's a superb tackle. Can he get it across? Well, Millwall get it away eventually, but only as far as Jones. Owusu's up there. Here's Walker. Nice control! And what a nice finish! Well, Yeovil go one up. James Walker. He scored against Gillingham on Sunday, and he's done it again. And it's a chance for Millwall to attack. Oh, they just can't get this ball clear, and that's in! Well, Jamie O'Hara has got the home side back on level terms after 71 minutes. Yeovil backtracking! Oh, so close! Chance for Millwall to break again. Yeovil a little bit on the back foot during these last few minutes. Here's Fusanini. Still Fusanini, and it's crept in! Well, it's crept in, and Ali Fusanini has surely given Millwall the lead and the winner.
Certainly it was a little bit scrappy in the first period for both teams, not too many opportunities, but in the second half, thought we started really well, deserved the lead, could have gone on and got a second goal. I thought they struggled most of the afternoon to break us down, to be honest, and I thought we were there for getting all 3 points, which would have been fantastic on the back of the Gillingham, but it's not to be, and we now look forward to the Bournemouth game and have to put things right again.
Well, Lloyd, obviously disappointing result, and it's frustrating, the inconsistency of Yeovil this season, isn't it?
Yeah, you're correct in that. We started off really well, but the recent form hasn't been the best. We've been a bit sort of missing hits. We haven't really been closing down teams enough, where we've been taking the leads, but just haven't been actually shutting teams down. Like on Saturday against Millwall, that happened. We took the lead, and then they scored 2 goals, and we were a bit unfortunate, but at the end of the day, that's football. We just got to make sure we're up for the next game on Tuesday.
Yeah, it's a tight league, of course, but you're a little bit off the pace at the moment. Is promotion still a realistic target?
Definitely. I mean, we're 9 points off the top. Promotion is definitely the target. We've done so well last season, and all the boys are out willing to do the best that they can do every Saturday and every Tuesday night. So hopefully we can start getting a good run of form in recent weeks, and then hopefully we'll be all right.
Of course, you've had more than your fair share of injuries. You personally have had some injuries this season. We're well used to seeing you with that bandage around your head, and that can't help, can it?
Oh no, I mean I've been in the wars, like you say. I've had a couple of head injuries. Only last Sunday I had the 5 stitches in my head. But like I say, I mean, I'm a warrior. I just got to carry on playing for the team and go for the cause, and that's what I've been doing.
So when those players come back, you're up to full strength. That's the time when you can really mount that charge.
Yeah, we've got some players, Mark Bertram, who hasn't even, no one's really seen him this season. Hopefully when he's back fully fit, he'll be back in the team and raring to go, and hopefully there's some other players coming through. So once everyone's there, I believe we'll be back up at the table.
I'm talking about players making their mark this season. James Walker, now you seem to have struck up a good little understanding with him, and he's a real young player to watch for, isn't he?
Yeah, James is a good player. I mean, he's not at Charlton for no reason. You know, I mean, luckily we've got him on loan here. He's only just turned 20 the other day. With his quality and his creativity that he's created so far in the team, and even he's got two goals in 2 games, which is brilliant. So hopefully with himself and the team, we can progress up the table.
Now, we mentioned Russell Slade earlier, a big influence on everyone, of course, at Huish Park. What kind of manager is he, and how does he manage to keep you all motivated?
He's really good. He reminds me a lot of my ways at when I was at Reading with Steve Coppell. Yeah. He's not really a ranting and raving kind of manager. He's very calm, a lot of respect for the players. I mean, he shows us a lot of respect, and he has a lot of trust in us, which I think is the main aspect in any manager. And we show him a lot of faith as well. So hopefully we can get the results for him especially.
And, of course, he had to lift you, didn't he, after that terrible FA Cup defeat at Torquay. I know that will interest a lot of our viewers, but that 4-1 setback down there was a heck of a blow, wasn't it?
Yeah, that wasn't nice for us, you know what I mean? Being the favourites to go to the game and win, we took the lead. But fair play to Torquay. They came out, they done a job on us. They scored the 4 goals, and all I can say is wish them best in the next round on Saturday.
Yeah, of course. And I just get the feeling you're enjoying your football at the moment, Lloyd.
Yeah, I am, because I mean I was out for a whole year last year, and just to get the chance again to play regularly every week in and week out and score goals, that's what any striker wants to do, and that's what I'm doing at the moment.
Yeah, you certainly like to celebrate a goal, don't you?
Yeah, I've had a bit of banter. A lot of my boys have been saying if I'm live on TV, just do something funny. So all my goal dedication going out to all my boys back home.
Okay, well, I've got the feeling we're going to be talking to you more about those goal celebrations a little bit later in the programme, and of course your very unique choice of music. But for the moment, thank you very much indeed.
Thank you.
Thank you. Yeah, good effort that, but here's a man who really knows how to celebrate when he gets it right. Well, Lloyd, some extravagant golf celebrations there. Talk us through them.
Oh, a lot of them just come sort of off the cuff. But there's been a couple where my boys back home and said, if I do score live on TV, have a little shake or a little wiggle. And that's what I've done there. And a few of the others as well. I've had a bit of banter with Terrell Forbes in the change room. He's also said, like, if you do score again, just do some little dancing celebrations. So that's where it's really come from.
You say they're off the cuff, but to be honest, one or two of them look well planned to me.
Yeah, definitely. You know what I mean? We have to sometimes plan things because you just don't know what's going to happen, but it's all a bit of fun. The boys like it. It's a bit of banter.
And the rest of the lads happy to join in?
A few of them. Nathan Jones, I don't think he's too impressed. I remember when we scored against Gillingham. I've run away and I'm waiting for Terrell to come over, and he's come over as well to try and celebrate. And I think he saw me waiting for Terrell. He didn't want to join in. He just said, forget that. So he went off, but it's all good.
Of course, you chose Jay-Z there for your choice of music, and a part-time DJ, of course, as well. And I think you choose the music for the dressing room, don't you?
Yeah, I mean, I've been DJing for the last 8-10 years, really. And like you say, I'm in charge of the music for the change rooms.
Any arguments there?
There's been a few. Scotty Guy tries to get involved and play a bit of his rock music, but I put the R&B and old school garage on, and a lot of boys do like that.
Yeah, it's important, isn't it, this music before kickoff, just to get everyone motivated. I mean, is it vital to the way the team approaches a game?
Yeah, definitely, because everyone needs that little bit of lift, that little oomph. And if you play a lot of bassline tunes with a lot of good meaning behind it, a lot of boys can inspire to that, and they can take that onto the pitch.
And what about Russell Slade? Does he like it?
The gaffers, he's hardly really in there. He's in there before, quick little in and out, and then he's out again. But I think he does like it deep down.
We mentioned earlier he'd signed a new contract now for a few more years. That's absolutely vital for a club like Yeovil to get Russell on a long-term basis.
Definitely, to get the security of the gaffer for, I believe, 2011. It's only going to be good for the club, and obviously with him being at the helm as well, a lot of players are going to want to come to Yeovil as well because they know he's done so well. So hopefully he's going to be there for the long term, and Yeovil will be going up the table as well.
And of course your next game, not at the weekend because you're out of the FA Cup, of course, as we mentioned earlier, but next Tuesday night against Bournemouth at Huish Park. Important to get a win there.
Yeah, massive game, local derby. We need to get a win. Like say we lost last Saturday, but hopefully we can get the result, get all the fans behind us, and then hopefully get the result, the 3 points on the table to move back up the table.
Yeah, fingers crossed you do. Lloyd, you've been a great guest tonight. Thanks for being with us on Soccer Night. Thanks
very much
indeed.
Cheers. Thank you.